Hey, it's CJ with Smoky Beginnings. Today, I'm going to show you how to make beef back ribs with an awesome Dr. Pepper BBQ sauce that will add a unique sweet and tangy flavor to your meat. If you've never heard of beef back ribs, don't worry, I'll explain everything later. Just know that they are a fantastic option for those who love hearty, meaty dishes packed with flavor and that they're an incredible alternative to pork ribs. In this video, I'll be showing you how to prepare the beef back ribs, how to season the ribs, how to smoke the beef back ribs, how to make a Dr. Pepper barbecue sauce, and of course, I'll be sharing some tips and tricks along the way. So if you're ready to make some incredible juicy and tender smoked beef ribs, let's go. Before we dive into cooking, let's go over a bit of background. What exactly are beef back ribs? They are a delicious and versatile cut of meat that can be enjoyed in many different ways, perfect for grilling, smoking, or slow cooking. They have a rich and flavorful taste that is sure to satisfy any meat lover. Where do beef back ribs come from? I'm glad that he asked. Beef back ribs come from the same part of the cow as baby back ribs, but they are larger and meatier. Some folks even call them shiners because the bones shine through once they are cooked. These ribs are cut from the rib cage of the cow right behind the ribeye, which is my favorite type of steak because of the outrageous marbling. Let me tell you a quick little story. The first time I tried the beef back ribs, I was at a family barbecue. My dad brought out these massive ribs, and I remember thinking to myself, geez, these ribs, they look like dinosaur bones. But when I took a bite, I was blown away by the flavor and the tenderness. Since then, I've been hooked. If you're like me and you love a good ribeye steak, you'll be thrilled with my latest video on making the most delicious ribeye sliders. And the best part, they come with the outrageous beer cheese dipping sauce. Stay tuned until the end of this video for a link to that video. And while I have you here, don't forget to like and subscribe for more great recipes. Why use Dr. Pepper in a barbecue sauce? Well, Dr. Pepper is a unique and delicious soft drink with 23 different flavors, which adds a ton of sweetness and tanginess to the meat. It's a popular ingredient in many barbecue recipes and is perfect for beef back ribs. The sweetness of the Dr. Pepper helps to balance out the savory flavor of the meat, while the tanginess adds a nice, unexpected kick to the dish. I believe the Dr. Pepper is a perfect marinade for beef back ribs, and I'll show you how to make a Dr. Pepper barbecue sauce later in this video. And I know you're wondering, how did I stumble across this incredible combination? I discovered it by accident. One summer, I was out of my usual barbecue sauce ingredients, and all I had in the fridge was a can of Dr. Pepper and some store-bought barbecue sauce. I thought, why not? I threw it into the mix, and the result was magical. After a few experiments with making my own sauce, it is now a staple in my toolkit. Now, let's move on to what you need for the Dr. Pepper barbecue sauce. You need 1 can of Dr. Pepper, 2 cups of ketchup, 1 cup of brown sugar, 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce, 1 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder, 1/2 teaspoon of onion powder, 1/2 teaspoon of paprika, and some honey. All you gotta do is add all the ingredients into a large saucepan and whisk together to combine. Place over medium heat and cook, stirring often until the mixture just starts to bubble. Then you're gonna lower the heat to a simmer and cook for about 5 minutes until the sugar is dissolved. Store in an airtight container in the refrigerator until it's ready. I have a whole video where I go more in depth in how to make this sauce. I'll leave a link in the description to that video. How to prepare the ribs. Start by removing the silver skin from the back of the ribs. This will help the smoke penetrate the backside of the meat more easily. You'll also want to square up the slab of the ribs by cutting off any loose hanging parts. And here's another story. I remember the first time I prepped the beef back ribs. I didn't know about the silver skin and left it on. The ribs were tasty, but a little bit of a tough chew. My neighbor, an old barbecue pro, laughed and said, "You always take off the silver skin. It's a secret to tender ribs." Lesson learned. Next, I'll be using Fire & Smoke Society's Cherry & Cola rub. This rub smells exactly like Cherry Coke. Before adding the rub, make sure to apply the binder, such as mustard, which will help the rub stick to the meat throughout the cook, leading to an awesome crust. Season the meat thoroughly and let the seasoning penetrate the ribs. Place the rib in a large baking dish or on a cookie sheet. Cover with plastic wrap and refrigerate for at least 2 hours for the best results. This allows the rub to really adhere to the meat and draw out some of the moisture to build a great bark. Now, speaking of that Fire & Smoke Society's Cherry Cola rub, how that came about that is I decided to try a new rub. My friends were skeptical, but when they bit into those ribs, their eyes lit up. "What did you put on them?" they asked. That's when I knew I had found a winner. Today, I'm going to smoke the ribs on a charcoal smoker. However, you can make these ribs on a grill or in an oven too. When you're ready to cook the ribs, preheat the smoker to 225 degrees to 250 degrees Fahrenheit. Place the ribs on the smoker away from the heat source, then close the lid and let the ribs take in the smoke. Our first check-in is at the 1 hour mark. This is to ensure that our smoker temp is dialed in and to see how the bark is forming. One way to tell if the bark is set is to press your finger onto the ribs. If your finger comes away clean, the bark is set. If your finger has a lot of seasoning on it, the bark needs more time to develop. In my case, the bark hasn't set, so I'll give it some more time. It's been about 2 hours, and it's time to check in on the ribs. And man, oh man, the color is developing nicely. Let's check the bark. And yep, it looks good to go, which means we can start our spritzing process. I have a spritzing bottle filled with Dr. Pepper and a little bit of water. Give the ribs a nice bath and then let them stay in the smoker. I'll come back every 30 minutes to repeat the spritzing process until we reach an internal temperature of 165 degrees Fahrenheit. Then about 3 hours, and we reached our first desired internal temperature of 165 degrees Fahrenheit. This is the point where the meat typically stalls or stays at a similar internal temperature for a really long time. To break the stall and have the ribs cook a little bit faster, I'll wrap them in aluminum foil and then put the ribs back in the smoker and check back in about an hour. So it's been about 4 hours of total cook time. 2 hours of cooking without the wrap, 2 hours with the wrap. I'm checking the internal temperature to see how close we are to my desired internal temperature of at least 200 degrees Fahrenheit. You don't have to hit that 200 degrees Fahrenheit temperature for the ribs to be done, but I found this to be a pretty good sweet spot. What you ideally want is the temperature probe to move in and out of the meat like a hot knife through butter. If you need a quality yet economical temperature pen, I have one link in the description. We aren't quite at our target time, so I'll give the ribs just a little bit more time. Patience is a virtue, right? It has now been 5 hours of total cook time, and as you can see, the temp probe is moving in and out of the meat with very little resistance. It's time to glaze the ribs with a Dr. Pepper sauce, then let them get nice and sticky before removing the ribs from the smoker. You also have a secondary option of to not put the barbecue sauce on at this point too. The only difference is you don't get that nice, sticky, tacky glaze on the rib. After removing the ribs from the smoker and letting them rest for about 10 minutes, it's time to devour them. So let's slice them up. Cut between the bones. When it comes to presentation, I like the raw and unkept way of placing the ribs onto a cutting board. It looks like you're arranging an archaeological site. I'll never forget the first time that I served these at a party. My friend's kids looked at the platter and said, "Wow, did you catch a dinosaur?" The look of amazement on his face was priceless, and everyone had a good laugh. And there you have it. Beef back ribs are a delicious and versatile cut of meat that can be enjoyed in many different ways, perfect for grilling, smoking, or slow cooking. They have a rich and flavorful taste that is sure to satisfy any meat lover. This recipe is easy to make and perfect for any occasion. I hope that you give it a try and let me know in the comments what is your favorite barbecue sauce to put on your ribs. Make sure to visit smokybeginnings.com for great recipes. If you like content like this, don't forget to like and subscribe, as that's the best way to support the channel. Or if you want to truly support this effort, you can buy me a coffee through the link in the description. Until next time, keep those fires burning and those taste buds tingling. Have a good one.